Hi guys, in this lesson, I'm going to discuss Border Gateway Protocol, BGP. Now, BGP is typically known as being a routing protocol that's used on the internet. And in the context of AWS and the exam, what we're looking at is how we can utilize BGP with our direct connect links and our site-to-site VPNs, and also direct connect gateway and transit gateway. So BGP is a protocol that we're able to use to exchange routing information over those connections. So let's have a look at some details around BGP. It's known as an exterior gateway protocol, and it's designed to exchange routing information on the internet. Now there's a concept which is called an autonomous system. ASs are collections of IP routing prefixes under the control of one or more operators. So an organization will control autonomous systems and the routing that takes place within them, but they might not necessarily have any control over other ASs. BGP is built on a system of trust in which routes are advertised and accepted between peers. So autonomous systems are able to peer with each other and routing information can be exchanged. Now that can be dynamic, but also it's to do with trust. So you can define which routes you want to accept into your routing tables. BGP is classified as a path vector routing protocol, and it exchanges the best path to a peer, and that's called the AS path. So essentially it's trying to find the best route to get to a destination. And we'll see shortly some of the details it uses to make those decisions. Autonomous system numbers, or ASNs, range from 0 to 65535, and the 64512 to 65534 are private and reserved. So all autonomous systems will have their own ASN. There are two implementations of BGP. First, we have the Interior Border Gateway Protocol, IBGP, and this is used for routing within an autonomous system. The Exterior Border Gateway Protocol, or EBGP, is then used for routing between autonomous systems. So let's learn about BGP visually. So here we have an autonomous system, and the ASN is 100, and it has its own CIDR block. We've then got AS200 and 300, and we have some peering relationships between them. So in this case, all of the autonomous systems are peered with each other. Let's have a look at the routing tables for these ASs. So these are obviously very simplified. We're just seeing a couple of paths between these autonomous systems. So we can see that to get to the 10.0.2 network, which is here, AS200, we go to AS200 and then we're there. So the I essentially indicates the destination and you've reached your destination. So very straightforward. There's no hops in between. For 20.0.3, we can also directly access that autonomous system. The BGP best path selection algorithm will select the shortest path to a destination. So in this case, that looks simple, and it kind of looks like that would be the best thing to do. So the shortest path to AS300 would be directly to AS300. And that's what BGP will select by default. The problem is that might not be the best path. It might look like the shortest path here, but in reality, that could be an extremely slow link, or it could be over a wide geographic area. The best path might actually be to go via 200. So that's something we'll look at shortly, how we can influence the routing decisions. Now let's introduce another autonomous system. We've got AS400, and we created some peering relationships here. It's not a full mesh though, so AS100 is not directly attached to AS400. So let's have a look at the routing table for AS400. So obviously we've got a path to 20.0.3 and that's direct. We've got a path to 20.0.2 and that's also direct. But then to get to 20.0.1, which is AS100, we had a couple of options here. We could have a route which goes from AS400 to AS300 and then to 100. That's exactly what we've got. So we've got 300, 100, and then we're there. Alternatively, we could have gone via 200. So 200 could also go to 100, and it's the same number of hops. So we have a choice there as to what we put into the route table. Now we can also add some additional routes to our other route table. So we have a direct connection to 20.0.4 from AS200, the same to 20.0.4 from AS300. And for autonomous system 100, we've got 2004 via 200, 400, so that's going this way. And we've got 2004 via 300, 400, that's going this way. So there are now two routes to get to the same destination. And we'll look in a moment at how we can influence which path to use. Now, it's worth noting that there are many more potential paths than shown here. Of course, for example, we could go from AS400 to 200, then to 300 and 100. And that might actually be the best path. Again, we don't know because we can't really see just from this diagram the bandwidth of the links, the geographical distances, and therefore the latency and various other parameters. So let's have a look at how we can influence routing. So I've simplified the diagram a bit. Now what I want to do in this case is I want all traffic to go from AS100 that's destined to 300, I want it to go via 200. So I want to make sure that all traffic to 300 goes to 200 and then from 200 to 300. So the way I can do that is with something called AS path prepending, and that's used to artificially lengthen the least preferred path. So what I've done here is I now have a longer path to get to the destination to AS300. Okay, so rather than just having 300i, I've put 300, 300, 300i. Now, of course, it looks a bit silly, but that actually works. And that's a way that you can make it look like it's a much longer path. Now, the path that I want the traffic to take is to 200, which is here, and then to 300. So the traffic to 300 will now go via 200 because that path is shorter than the artificially lengthened path. So that's AS path prepending. Now there are several other selection attributes when BGP is determining the path to take. So it does depend on the router, and there are several attributes that are considered in the path selection decisions. Now these include, and I'm just choosing some that are likely to come up on the exam, there are some more. So local preference, and that's used within an AS, and the highest local preference is preferred. The default is 100. Then there's the AS path length, and we've just looked at that. So the shortest AS path length is preferred. So for example, 100, 200, 300 is shorter than 100, 200, 201, 300. Next, there's the multi-exit discriminator, or MED. And in this case, the path with the lowest MED is preferred. Then there's eBGP over iBGP. So eBGP will be preferred over iBGP.